Oh, yes. Hey, can you turn on the house lights just for a second? I want to see who's here. How many people were here last time we came to town? All right. So you were listening. That's awesome. Thank you so much, you guys. Look at, that's a good looking bunch, huh? I had somebody text me and say they knew we were going to be in West Virginia. And he wanted to know, is it true all the girls look like Daisy Duke down here? I said, you better believe it. Whole place is Daisy Duke. You guys ready? This is a newer one. One of my favorites. And that girl, she just can't help it. Thank you. Give it up for Chuck on the keyboards over here. I got the great joy to sing with that band, and it was fun while it lasted. But I have found that the music, that music will be here forever, Long after I'm gone, long after they're gone, their music will live on for generations and generations. I kind of consider the Journey, friends of mine, to kind of be like the American Beatles. That's kind of how I put it. The American Beatles. So melodic and iconic. Don't you agree? So we're all playing musical chairs up here. What's that? Yeah, baby. Did you bring any of that with us for everybody? Or just... All right. This one here. Man, this one kicks butt. Thank you. By the way, this is Mikey Higgins over here, playing the acoustic guitar, playing the piano. He can play just about everything up here. And I'll tell you, his baby brother back there on the drums, that's Timmy Higgins back there on the drums. And this next guy I'm going to introduce to you, this is the first time he's played with the band in about 5 years. He came in as a sub, and now he's a permanent bass player. Give it up for Randy Riley. Yes? What was that? Something back there. Nothing important, right? No. Anyway, the Journey guys and I actually met just hanging out in the San Francisco area when I lived out there. And we started writing songs, we started like starting bands. And one of the bands that came out of that fun time in my life was a band called The Storm. She remembers that. She does. Ask her about it after the show, okay? Anyway, we really did well. It was a top 20 hit. Greg Raleigh and I wrote it together and we sang it together. A song called I've Got a Lot to Learn About Love. We're gonna play it right now.
Yeah.
heard that song once or twice, huh? Well, you know, speaking of Greg Raleigh, he's in the Hall of Fame twice now. He went in with Santana and just went in with Journey. I predicted that. I want you to know, in 1991, I told him. He was like, yeah, we'll never get in. Oh, yeah. So I'm real proud of those boys, and especially Greg, because we spent a lot of time on the road together, a lot of time in the studio together. And Mikey really does a fine job with Greg Raleigh's vocals. So give it up for Mikey again. Open my eyes to a new kind of way. And all the good times that you say, anyway. How you feeling? You're feeling like way too. Oh, am I just? Am I just a fool? you old timers. Been listening to the Journey since the 70s. Thank you so much. Hey, this is a great place, and we love coming back to Wheeling Isle. People treat us really good here. You all come out, treat us good. Just show up, and we're happy. You know what I'm saying? We're happy. We're going to play anyway, so you might as well be here, have a good time with us, and thank you for doing that. It means a lot to us. Okay, now, these two guys are going to start this one. With this band, huh? They have been with me and very loyal, and it feels good to play music with these guys. I want to tell you, hey, if nobody else will, just be good to yourself, okay?
Situation. So I'm a child.
guys are doing your part tonight. I just want you to know that. You are really doing your part. They clap once in a while. They yell. They cheer. They do rock and roll, like crowd stuff. Real stuff. Yes. Now, my favorite Journey song of all time, Jerry.
To hold you, I'd go anywhere.
Are there any Pittsburgh Steelers fans here tonight? Won't you just one more time, please. Very important message. Can you turn on the house lights, please? Okay, there you go. Are there any service people in here tonight? Armed forces? Any armed forces? People who have served? Could you just do us the honor of please standing? Please stand up and let's show them some love, yes. Thank you, guys. Listen, man. Come on. We got more love than that. Come on, give it up for these people. You don't put your life on the line and just get some, like, little bit of clappage. God bless you guys. All right. That's right. Do we have any policemen? Any firemen? You know, first responders. Anybody else? Because you know what? I know how important you people are because you saved my life too. All right? So, we're so blessed to be able to be here, to be in the United States of America. Any proud Americans here tonight? I don't know what side of the aisle you're on, but it doesn't matter because really, we're right down the middle. We're all Americans and we need to respect and love one another and take care of one another and stop arguing about stupid stuff. Huh? And quit sending, like, don't get me started. Chuck's hands are going to fall off of it. Anyway, God bless you people. America, land that I love, I stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountain.
Put a flag in front of your house, man. That's a message.
We are so blessed to be able to be here in the United States of America. See, we've gotten complacent. We have. We've gotten... You can't have a blessing unless you appreciate it. We got to be able to appreciate our blessings. I hope we don't have to lose it to appreciate it. Man, so important. Come on, let's get it together. Starting right now. Come on, Timmy. Take us there.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world.
I want to tell you, we brought some CDs, some t-shirts and stuff. Chuck, as soon as we get done. And it looks like we're done.